first word that springs to mind is community. It is just a really happy community. Everybody pulls together, the teachers, the parents, everyone is together and equal and celebrated, and yeah, fantastic community. So I've got two who finished here and are at secondary and two who are still at the school. They all run in without a backward glance every morning, really happy to be here. Yeah, the teachers make it engaging and fun, and it's just a very happy place to be. And so they really thrive in their learning as well, because they're happy and supported.
The teachers are fantastic. The learning, they're passionate about learning. The children do learn, but it's not just about that. They're cared for, they're supported emotionally. And that says a lot about the staff here, I think.
Oh, it's fantastic. It's got brilliant grounds for the kids. The teachers are all approachable, friendly. They want to do the best for the children, especially when children might have other challenges with confidence or self-esteem, or, you know, they spend the extra time with them. We actually moved to the area 3 years ago. So we looked at lots of schools, lots of houses around the area, and we loved this school. And we actually live on the other side of Whitney. So we come all the way across every day from town because my children are happy. They're really happy here.
I'd say it's fun and friendly. No one hurts each other, no one makes fun, no one's really mean. They're just all there for you, and if you're sad, then the class will come over, not they just don't leave you. They're really kind.
Yeah, the staff are really friendly. Mm-hmm. It's easy to talk to them when there's something wrong with you.
I think what's really important to me as the head teacher of the school is that every child is valued for what they can do. And that may be maths or English, but it might be that they're going to be the next, you know, famous musician or artist. And whatever it is, we will bring the best out in the children. And all my staff want to do that. And we encourage them with things that perhaps they don't find as easy, and we support them. But at the same time, we'll encourage what they are good at as well. And we offer a very broad curriculum, which gives them opportunity to excel at something.
We try to do as much outdoor learning as we can so that the children are using the environment, because we are very lucky to have the environment we have. Mm. And the swimming pool is a big part of it as well. They use the swimming pool and the sports. The children try to embrace all the sports, and we try to do competitions within the school and with other schools in the community. A growth mindset is a really key thing that we try to install in our children, to let the children know that actually it doesn't matter if you can't do something yet, that actually through hard work and perseverance that you can get there, and that mistakes are part of learning. So our children here, they sometimes refer to things, oh, I've made a marvellous mistake, because they don't see it as a negative. They see it as a positive, that, oh, I've learned something, and actually tomorrow I'll come back a bit stronger and I'll learn from that and I'll persevere and I will get there. And you'll often see that I haven't got there yet. And that's kind of, the Yeti's a bit of a kind of figure in our school.
Yeah, our strap line is caring, learning and succeeding together. And it's, they know we'll support them. They know that it doesn't matter if they're stuck. There's things they can do, and we teach them. They can ask their peers. There's always working walls that they can use in classrooms. They know they can go certain places. They can get dictionaries if it's English and things. And they know that that support is there from the teacher and the staff that are around the school.
And we try to teach the children, yes, to flourish as individuals, but also that the teamwork and the community is really important, that actually we work together and we help one another. And when sometimes someone will be struggling, it might be you next time, and we help each other out. And I think you can definitely feel that when you come into our school, that you can feel that sort of ethos that we're trying to build.
We open at 8 o'clock, and children can come if parents need to go to work. They can have breakfast if they want to. That's their choice. And we offer lots of nice cereals, toasts, crumpets, and very occasionally they might get a bacon sandwich if they're lucky, and the staff. And then obviously they're here for their day, but then parents aren't always able. Obviously the big push is that parents are at work and they can't always pick them up straight away. But my staff run, it's all run by staff from the school, and they run an after-school club, and it'll have, they have 10 minutes reading, then they have a bit of fun, they'll go outside, they can use the outdoors again, they might use the forest school, they do art, they often do cooking. It's not school, but it has an expectation of the correct behaviour in school, but actually it's about, well, it's after school now, but if they want to finish homework or something, that's fine, they'll be supported. But then parents can pick up any time up to 6 o'clock. And that's been really welcomed by parents in the last 2 or 3 years. They've been really pleased that the children love it. Some of them just choose to go there, they don't have to. And my staff enjoy offering that slightly less formal sort of curriculum as well. We've just opened a nursery, so we now have children in age 2, right through to 11. And that's been a goal of mine for a long time. And with the excellent leadership of Emily Taylor and Donna McGowan, we're very excited by this, because from 2 to 5, they're getting a very hands-on, practical, but very focused, but learning from what they're interested in and taking their learning with them.
We'll start with the child. It's always about the child. So we get to know the child, we get to know where they're coming from, so their family background, where they've been before, what their interests are, and we take their learning from there, from their starting point, from their interests, and that's where we move them on. So as soon as we know that they're coming to us, we'll start finding out about them, finding out where we're going to take them. And then that's how it carries on then throughout the school time in early years. It's all about the child-centred learning. If they come in one morning and they're interested in something, we will run with that. And that can sometimes be really infectious, because one 4-year-old loves something or 3-year-old loves something, then quite likely some others do as well. So we run with that. And the engagement levels are very high, which means that we've got children learning all the time, and we have lots of really quality interactions with children throughout the day, where we're teaching them lots of teachable moments that happen. We'll ask at home what things are they into right now? What's happening in their lives right now? Maybe there's a new sibling. Maybe there's a wedding abroad. Maybe somebody's died. You know, something that we need to know that we can work with. So that happens. But then we also do much more set things. So we have a maths mastery meeting. We call it the maths meeting. It's just at their level for the amount of time that they can concentrate and engage. And very practical mastery techniques, looking at numbers in great depth. And we also have phonics, which is our read, write, ink scheme. Children really love that. Starts off very small, building up, learning sounds, learning to read, learning to write very quickly, and lots of wonderful listening games and attention games to get them in that right frame of mind for that kind of learning. But the rest of it is child-led. We are very, very lucky with our wonderful green space, and the children absolutely love it. And there's so much outside that they can learn from. Lots of inquiry and curiosity outside for them. And also we can then move from our garden, which they spend, you know, every day they can go out and utilise. We've actually got our lovely forest school area. So we take groups of children there where we can extend learning, extend challenge, and just extend curiosity. As soon as we know that a child is coming here, we make contact with their current provision. So if they're in a nursery, a childminder, preschool, we'll go and talk to that provision, find out a little bit about them already. We'll go in and visit them there, so see them in that space, talk to the people who work with them day to day now at this point in time, start to learn a little bit about what makes them tick, what they're interested in, what they can achieve at the moment, things they might find tricky, things they really excel at. Then we will also talk to the parents. So we'll have lots of parent meetings. We'll invite parents in. We'll invite children in for taster sessions. And then just before they begin, we do a home visit. So we go to their house and we meet the child, meet the parents. Sometimes we meet grandparents as well. You'd be amazed how many people sometimes gather for us to meet them. And we have just a 10-minute chat on the sofa, anything that they want to ask. And I think it's children in their own space. They feel comfortable. We're meeting them in their place. They feel more comfortable to talk about things and behave in a way that's natural for them. Parents feel at ease. They're in their home space. They may have a list of things. They're not in a hall with a big PowerPoint. We have that too, but they have this other opportunity to talk face to face, one to one. And children remember it. You know, year sixes will turn around and say to me, "Do you remember when you came to my house? I remember I was holding this toy. Do you remember?" And you know what I do?
I would recommend this school to anyone. It is a great place for kids to learn, and as a parent, it's a lovely community to be a part of.
I tell them to just come in and have a look around and trust their gut, because when they see the children in the classrooms, in the playground, they'll see how approachable all the teachers are. they'll understand that this will be the right place for them.